Actually, I didn't know the title of the exhibition. I think that following the conversation that we just had downstairs, I hope that through making art and the conversations that I'm having through sculpture or painting or whatever, is that hopefully it's not only just an expression of me, but also reaching out, hopefully to the viewer, but also hopefully to other practitioners in an attempt to claim ownership of our world, right? It's not necessarily just ownership, but also to embody the world that we live in. So I think that that's probably a relationship to the title that could be drawn. It's not necessarily just in the artwork, but rather in the sort of chutzpah or the force that drives the work in general. I'm hoping that there's the work that I make, what I'm trying to do is that I can say it like this, that my body is experiencing my environment now, that my brain is responding to how I understand your question and how am I going to respond to that. My left foot is a little bit uncomfortable. My jeans are too hot. I wish I was wearing shorts and so is this jacket. So, but with saying that is that I'm experiencing the world around me all the time. So there's death, there's humor, there's sorrow, there's terror, there's joy, there are all of these things. And so these are all things that I'm experiencing. So as things come out of me, I hope that I am trying to create a greater spectrum of meaning so that I can truly talk about the world that I live in. But humor and attention to detail. Humor is a way of inviting you into a conversation with me. Nobody's ever started a conversation with a punch. Americans try to do that a lot. American politicians try to do that a lot, right? Behind shielded vehicles in faraway countries. Personally, I don't know anybody that's ever had an effective conversation by hitting you. So humor is a way to seduce you into a conversation, as is to make something very purposeful, absolutely purposeful, so that the material and the meaning are combined together into one cohesive force thing. Yeah. I don't believe that there's yesterday, because right now, as we stand here, the person that we all are is the accumulation of all of human history, whether we like it or not. And so, as now happens, it's subsumed by the past of history, which is not linear. It moves in all directions. And as now happens, now is constantly being absorbed into this thing. This thing is like, I think that it's like you step 1 foot out and 1 foot back. You're constantly on the precipice of the edge of this thing that I'm talking about. So you're at once the past and you're at once in the present, but the present never really happens because the present and the future are just like the same thing almost, constantly moving out. So I think that 1968 is as alive as 1862, as any other time that you might want to, because all of these things are predicated on all of the events that happened previously. All of these events come to make the meaning of now.